This is a genuinely frightening prospect. Will you tie that for me, Chris? Nice and tight. Great.
Okay.
Fantastic. Okay. All right. I'm going to leave you to make the course. Could you see through this blindfold?
No.
No. Fantastic.
Whilst I know the shape of the course, I have no idea which path Chris will leave safe for me. And to restrict my balance even more, I ask him to tie my hands behind my back.
Chris, now I cannot see a thing, but just so that people at home trust that, I'm going to ask you to do one more thing for me. As you leave, you'll see there's the box on the cables and plugs for the lights run into. On top of that is a key. When you turn that key, all the lights will go out. The room will be plunged into absolute darkness. Then you'll go out, you'll close the door, sealing me in alone, and you'll be taken through to the control room where you'll be given a headset and we can carry on talking.
Darren, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, Chris. You should have in front of you four monitors connected to night vision cameras.
Correct.
That's three cameras that are fixed along this course, and the fourth one is a remote camera which can be controlled by Aaron, who should be sat next to you in the control room. Can you see all of that? Does that make sense?
Yes, I can see it, yes.
Okay, fantastic. Now, Chris, listen very, very carefully. I am going to ask you for directions across this course. When you give me your answers, you can lie or you can tell the truth. It is up to you. My job is to correctly read your vocal signals and maneuver myself safely across the course. Does that make absolute sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Now, I may try to trick you into telling me the truth, but no matter how much I plead or beg or cry like a brownie, don't buckle. Your job is to mislead me. That makes sense?
Yes.
Then we shall start. First one, though, I would like you to be honest about, just so that I can hear what you're like when you're telling the truth. So just to start with, just for the first one, is it right, left, or forward? Then that's my right and my left.
Right.
I go right. I cannot believe you fell for that one, Chris.
Okay.
All right. Now, you've probably been in a position where you've had to tell whether or not somebody was lying. What things in their voice would you listen for?
Maybe a bit of nervousness.
A bit of nervousness, hesitation?
Yes.
Is it forward, right, or left now?
Right.
You were so careful to hide any hesitation there, Chris. I think it can't be left because I've just been there, so it must be forward. You are obviously fibbing. These are 4 paces long, given my stride. What size feet have you got, Chris?
9s.
So at home, would you prefer a moccasin or a more conventional slipper?
Never wear slippers.
Is it right, left, or forward here?
It is right.
You said that with a strange, conspicuous roll of the R. You're obviously a little self-conscious. Let me do this one again. Is it right, left, or forward?
It is left.
I'm going to go forward. Chris, tell me your full name.
Chris Ryan.
What's your mother's maiden name?
Jackson.
What's your father's maiden name?
He doesn't have.
Is it right, left, or forward?
It is left.
Strange sort of hesitation there. Don't believe you, I'm going forward. I'm going to back up. I think I was a little too cocky there. Hang on. God. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me do this one again. Okay, Chris, sorry. Will you say right for me?
Right.
Say left.
Left.
Right, left. I'm sorry. Hang on. Sorry, Chris, I've genuinely got myself in a muddle here.
I need to genuinely hear whether it is right or left. Can I just ask you just this one time to tell me honestly, is it right or left?
Trust me, take a left.
Are you being honest with me? Is it really left, or are you just saying that because you think I'm trying to catch you out? I'm not trying to catch you out. Is it left? Is it really left?
Trust me, it's left.
There's no way after I caught you out the first time that you'd do that again. And I don't trust you'll trust me. I'm going down here. If I've remembered the course correctly, I am now at the end of the course. I think I'm on the middle of the three podia at the end. Chris, I'm going to number these. Let me just work my way across here. This we will call podium number one. Podium number one, all right?
Okay.
Get back. This is number two. And the next one is number three. Now, Chris, you've placed the crash mat under just one of these three podia. I need to know which one of these is safe for me to jump off. So I'm going to ask you the same question three times. Chris, you give me the same answer three times. And the answer is always yes. Podium number one, is it safe?
Yes.
Podium number two, is it safe?
Yes.
Podium number...
Find out what happens after the break. I have successfully maneuvered across a dangerous assault course blindfolded despite misleading directions from this special forces soldier. Now I have one last obstacle.
Now, Chris, you've placed the crash mat under just one of these three podia.
I need to know which one of these is safe for me to jump off.
So I'm going to ask you the same question three times. Chris, you give me the same answer three times. And the answer is always yes. Podium number one, is it safe?
Yes.
Podium number two, is it safe?
Yes.
Podium number...
Usually you can tell by their eyes or possibly body movement, but obviously he didn't have any of them. It was absolutely amazing. I'd have liked to seen him fail. That was the whole idea. And I'd have liked to seen it happen, but unfortunately it didn't.
Staten Island Ferry is a good place to pass the time for free. Can I use my powers of suggestion to plant a thought in a sightseer's mind?
Hi, so what's your name?
Liz.
Liz, very nice to meet you. Thanks for doing this. Do you wear a watch? Can I borrow it for a second?
Yes.
Would you take it off for me? Is it right if I change the time on it?
That's fine.
Lovely. Thank you very much indeed. It's very nice. Okay. I've changed the time. I want you to put it back on your wrist, but without looking at the time. Okay, so no looking at it. In fact, put your hand over it. In fact, just do that without looking. Okay, all right. I'm going to try and transmit a time to you, the time that I've set the watch to.
Okay.
Okay, I want you to see if you can pick up what it is. So imagine a clock face in your mind.
Okay.
Try and do it with your eyes open if you can. And there are, obviously you're going to get two hands that are going to appear on the clock face as you look at it. So first of all, we're going to start with the larger of the two hands,
okay.
All right, which would be the number of minutes past, okay? So as you look at the clock face and imagine that other hand somewhere on there. What, it doesn't have to be exactly on a number, but what number is the larger of the two hands on? Where do you see it?
Close to the two.
Okay, that would be 10 past something. Spot on 10 past, or are you going to go
a bit
before or a bit after?
A little before.
A little bit before, okay. And the hour hand, just have a look in your mind, go around, look at all the numbers. Where do you see the hour hand?
Close to the 10.
Close to the 10. So if you look at the clock now, what time does it say?
10:09.
Have a look, I won't touch it. What does it say?
10:09.
Oh, that's crazy. God.
You got it spot on. You even got the 09.
That's insane.
That's not even right.
I'm like shaking. That's crazy.
When he said to just kind of imagine the two hands, that's kind of what I did. I kind of had a set time in my head that I was already going to say, but then as I was kind of going through the process that he was walking me through, the time changed.